إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه نثني عليه الخير كله نعبده ولا نشركه ولا نكفره ونترك ونخلع كل من يكفره ويزجره. اللهم إياك نعبد ولك نصلي ونسجد وإليك نسعى ونحفد، نرجو رحمتك ونخشى عذابك، إن عذابك الجد بالكفار ملحق. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة شهد بها لنفسه في كتابه فقال: إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري. إن الساعة آتية أكاد أخفيها لتجزى كل نفس بما تسعى، فلا يصدنك عنها من لا يؤمن بها واتبع هواه فتردى. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا وقائدنا وأسوتنا رسول الخير سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن اقتفى أثره واتبع هداه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين، محمداً عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خيرة خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فصلاةً وسلاماً دائمين متلازمتين عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. أما بعد، أوصيكم ونفسي الخاطئة بتقوى الله العظيم، وأحذر نفسي وإياكم من عصيان أمره ومخالفة شريعته، مصداقا لقول الحق سبحانه وتعالى: فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره، ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His help, we invoke Him, we beseech Him to send the salutation upon the final and the last messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him. I bear witness and testify that there is no one worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I bear witness and testify that the Prophet Muhammad, he is the final and the last messenger. I encourage myself before you all to achieve the taqwa, piety and righteousness, and be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He warning all of us in His glory book, the noble words, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned in the Quran and said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Oh believer, oh believe, people of iman, people of faith, people of taqwa, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not die except in Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of us steadfastness and to make us among those who are dying as Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us a good end. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا. Oh believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and always say the truth, speak the truth, and whomsoever will do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rectify and guide his actions, his deeds. And whomsoever obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive the sins, ويصلح لكم أعمالكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. And whomsoever obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger, indeed he will be among the winners of this life or the successful one in this life and hereafter. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among them. Allahumma ameen. My dear brothers, respected elders and sisters in Islam, the topic that I would like to share with you today, regardless to the known deception or al-khid'atu al-ma'rufa aw al-ma'luma, that has been known, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one emphasizing to us. He is the one clarified to us and made it clear to us. إن الشيطان لكم عدو فاتخذوه عدوا إنما يدعو حزبه ليكونوا من أصحاب السعير. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في محكم التنزيل, Allah mentioned in His glory book that the shaitan is the biggest enemy for you. Deal with it or deal with him as an enemy, or take him as an enemy. Because he's only call his people, call his followers to join him, to be with him in hellfire. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of us from the whispering of the shaitan and from the consequences of fire. Allahumma ameen. In Surah Saba, very beautiful ayah that emphasizes the tricks of the shaitan, the deceptions of Iblis, and how he tricks people, and he comes from the left and right, and from the front and from the back, tricking people, misleading people, misguide people, because this is his job, and this is what he wants people to join him in fire. May Allah protect all of us. وَلَقَدْ صَدَّقَ عَلَيْهِمْ إِبْلِيسُ ظَنَّهُ فَاتَّبَعُوهُ إِلَّا فَرِيقًا مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. صدق, أحكم. He makes sure that the people are going to follow him. And they followed him. Except فَرِيقًا مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. A group of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed His mercy on them. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala select them to be among the guided one. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among them. إِلَّا فَرِيقًا مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَمَا كَانَ لَهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us He doesn't have any power or authority over them. إلا لنعلم من يؤمن بالآخرة. The fact of it that we are going to know who is going to believe in hereafter or believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والله على كل شيء حفيظ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one. Shaitan, what comes after? Protection. حفظ of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because He doesn't going to do anything to you or harm you, except if you are going away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you're not following the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَتَخَبَّطُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. That the shaitan will touch them or mess. مَسُّم مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. That Allah shaitan will be affected or afflicted with the shaitan. Because they dealt with something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited for them. They are aware or they are unaware from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and who is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to do so we can protect us from the whispering of the shaitan. وَمَا كَانَ لَهُمْ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. Allah is the one who said that. In fact, the shaitan on the day of judgment will scream and say the liquid speech.
إن الله وعدكم وعد الحق ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم، فما كان لي عليكم من سلطان إلا أن دعوتكم فاستجبتم لي، فلا تلوموني ولوموا أنفسكم، ما أنا بمصرخكم وما أنتم بمصرخي، إني كفرت بما أشركتموني من قبل. Scary ayah from Surah Ibrahim that we should reflect upon it. What the shaitan wants from us? What the shaitan wants from the son of Adam? What did the shaitan do to Adam alayhi salam to bring him from paradise to this life? Of course, everything in the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, everything in the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It meant to be that we all to come to this universe. إِلَّا لِنَعْلَمَ مَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِالْآخِرَةِ. This is the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us, to select us, to choose us. Whomsoever going to follow his path, he will be among the guided one. And whomsoever will mislead from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, خَابَ وَخَسِرَ. Despaired and lose the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what the shaitan wants. فَرِّقْ تَسُدْ. Divide, you will be the king. You will be the owner. You're going to be the controller. This is some people going with this methodology. This is the tricks of the shaitan, whispering of the shaitan. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, قَالَ قَائِلْ. A beautiful poem. That he said, إِنِّي ابْتُلِيتُ بِأَرْبَعٍ مَا سُلِّتُ إِلَّا لِأَجْلِ شَقَاوَتِي. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's just like reflecting upon this four things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testing him with. And he write these beautiful words. إِنِّي ابْتُلِيتُ بِأَرْبَعٍ. And I want to bring your attention to these four things. Because the Prophet and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasize all of them in the Quran. Everything according to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the teach, or how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reflect upon the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is our source of guidance. Without them, we'll live in misleading. We'll be misled. We'll be misguided. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. Allahumma ameen. إني ابتليت بأربع ما سلّت إلا لأجل شقاوتي. That you only assigned to mislead me. إبليس والدنيا والهوى. إبليس والدنيا ونفسي والهوى. The shaitan, the life, my own self, and desire. These four things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested us with. Shaitan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it there to test you. Are you going to deal with him as an enemy? Are you going to protect yourself from the shaitan? Following the whispering of the shaitan, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ من الجنة والناس. An ayah. It's a full protection. Surah in the Quran to seek protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some other ayats that you can include to protect yourself. Because the jinn is a alam, is a universe that we live and we deal with them. But they cannot harm anyone. As he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as the shaitan said, he in fact proved it against himself. I cannot harm anyone except that I call you to follow me and you followed me. فَلَا تَلُومُونِي. Do not blame me, blame yourself. Because you are the one who followed him. مَا أَنَا بِمُصْرِخِكُمْ وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُصْرِخِي. I'm not going to save you and you are not going to save me. إِنِّي كَفَرْتُ بِمَا أَشْرَكْتُمُونِ مِنْ قَبْلِ. I already disbelieve what you are going through now. What the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called you, what all the messengers came, because this speech is going to be for all mankind. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised you the trust promised. The promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the right promises. وَعَدَكُمْ وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ وَوَعَدْتُكُمْ. And I became and I tricked you and whispered to you. فَأَخْلَفْتُكُمْ. And I misled you. This is the speech of the shaitan in the Quran. He is the one going to speak on the Day of Judgment. Are we blaming ourselves or blaming the shaitan? What are these four things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protecting us from or testing us with? الشيطان والنفس. شوف النفس. إن النفس لأمارة بالسوء. That our souls or ourselves committed us to do something wrong sometimes. She recognized and she realized that she did something evil. Who is that? The wife of the prime minister of Egypt. In the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ. I'm saying the facts now. I realize that I commit something evil because my nafs, my soul commit me to do that. إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي. إِنَّ رَبِّي غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Except those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in His mercy. On them we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among them. Allahumma ameen. وَالدُّنْيَا وَالْهَوَى. Life could be tricky. Life could trick you or mislead you. Take advantage in the right way. إِنَّمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. This life, غُرُور, غَرَّاء, drag you down, hold you down. Rather you take advantage of it and do good and do righteous deeds in it, you will save yourself and protect yourself. As Imam al-Shafi'i, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on him, he says, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ عِبَادًا فُطَنَ طَلَّقُوا الدُّنْيَا وَخَافُوا الْفِتَنَ نظروا فيها فلما علموا أنها ليست للحي وطنا جعلوها لجة واتخذوا فيها صالح الأعمال سفنا. Beautiful reflection from the righteous people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the great people, the futana, realistic people of this life. The intelligent people, that they think about the reality of this life. A brother who was given the khutbah a few weeks ago, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يعني, reward him from the khutbah that he shared with the community about the reality of life in this dunya. It was beautiful. And look at this words, beautiful words. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ عِبَادًا فُطَنَ. That in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his special people are very intelligent. They think about this life. طلقوا الدنيا. They despair this life. They don't want this life. وخافوا الفتنة. They afraid and they fear from the temptation and the trials of this life. نظروا فيها. And they look at it from different view, from different angel. فلما علموا. And after they realized. أنها ليست للحي وطنا. It is not for those who are going to live as a life. Living, إنما الحياة الدنيا في الآخرة. That the life is going to be in hereafter. جعلوها لج. لج. فلما دخلت الصرف حسبته لج فكشفت عن ساقيها. When Bilqis entered to the castle of King Sulaiman, and she saw the water, because the glass was clear, She thought this is the water. So lujja here, ja'aluha lujjatan, they made it as a ocean, as a sea, as a pond, and they put the pot on it, and they did righteous, so they can save themselves. فَاتَّخَذُوا صَالِحَ الْأَعْمَالِ فِيهَا سُفُنًا. What is going to save you? What is going to drive you from the temptation of this life is your righteous deeds. Is your good deeds. Izra tahsud. Plants, good, you will harvest good. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who are rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from the whispering of the shaitan. قولوا قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اقتفى. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين وصل على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. صلاة ترضى بها عنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وأدخلنا في صحبته وزمرته مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. اللهم آمين آمين آمين. أما بعد، من أطاع مولاه وجاهد نفسه وهواه وخالف شيطانه كانت الجنة مأواه. Again. من أطاع مولاه وخالف نفسه وشيطانه فإن الجنة مأواه. Whomsoever obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he put efforts to fight with himself against his own desires, فإن الجنة مأواه. Indeed, that the Jannah is going to be the final destiny for him. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about that?
وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى وَأَمَّا مَنْ خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى.
For those who are recognizing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they know the maqam and the position of Allah, of their lords, and he commit himself or avoid himself from following his own desires. فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Jannah is the final and the last destiny. فَأَمَّا مَنْ طَغَى وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. And for those who are wrongdoers themselves in this life, يَطْغُونَ طَاغِيَة, by doing bad deeds and evil deeds, يَطْغِيَ الظُّلْمَ عَلَى الْحَقِّ, by doing bad deeds over the good deeds, وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, and they following the desires of this life, مَا لَهُمْ إِلَّا النَّارِ فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from the hellfire and to protect all of us from the consequences of fire. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, what is all this evidence coming from? Everything has a proof. And this is the beauty of our religion. Prove to me that. قال الله قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned. Isn't that beauty? It's a beauty of our deen. One of the great scholars of Islam mentioned, after he started writing about the Quran in his book, And he says, بدأت ببسم الله أولا. I start with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first of all. Or first of all, I start with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم صليت على النبي المختار أحمد. And I sent salutation upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which is called him Ahmad. وثلست أن الحمد لله دائما أبدا. And third, all praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everlasting. All the time, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the grateful ni'mah that you have. And seek protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the temptation of this life. And then he says, وَبَعْدُ فَحَبْلُ اللَّهِ فِينَا كِتَابُهُ فَجَاهِدْ بِهِ حِبْلَ الْعِدَى مُتَحَبِّلًا. What is going to protect all of us from the shaitan? What is going to protect all of us from our own selves? Even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used to open his khutbah, he used to say, وَنَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا. Blame yourself. Don't blame other people. وَنَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا. We seek refuge in you from our own evil self. وَمِنْ سَيِّئَاتِ أَعْمَالِنَا. It's our sins that we commit. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all. Lastly, I'll wrap with this hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, قال الشيطان لله وعزتك وجلالك لأغوينهم ما دامت أرواحهم فيهم. The shaitan said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will keep misleading them as long as their soul is still in their bodies. Because we all know, وَلَأُضِلَّنَّهُمْ وَلَأُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ وَلَأَمُرَنَّهُمْ فَلَا يُغَيِّرُنَّ خَلْقَ اللَّهِ. This is what the shaitan promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's going to mislead people. ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. I will come to them from their left and their right, from the front, from the back, and at the end, you would not find anyone grateful to you. But what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond to this? Allah is the merciful. Allah is the most compassion. Allah is the ra'uf. Ar-Rahim al-Ghafoor. خَلَقَنَا وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِنَا. He created us and He do know what we need from this life and from hereafter. Just go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Repent to Him. Seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Astaghfirullah. Remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. By my majesty, لَأَسْتَغْفِرَنَّ لَهُمْ مَا دَامُوا يَسْتَغْفِرُونَنِي. You keep misleading them, they will come, do you keep backing, or do you keep coming back to me? And I will forgive their sins. As long as they keep seeking refuge in me, I will forgive them. May Allah forgive our sins. May Allah shower all of us His mercy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from the whispering of the shaitan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from the temptation of this life. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our difficulties. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our affairs. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put His barakah and ni'mah and all of His نعم أبن all of us. اللهم آمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا. ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلاة وسلاما على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين.